Welcome to Rasashastra class. Myself JB and Dr. Devasish Panigai. Today we are going to discuss a chapter on tamra, that is copper in English, with various Sanskrit synonyms like sulba, raktaka, mlechchavaktra, tryambaka, suryaloha, twastra, अर्क, द्विष्ट, द्वयष्ट, अंबक, उदुम्बर, अरविंद, सूर्यांग, लोहितायस, रविप्रिय, भास्कर, ताम्रक एंड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द सिनोनिम्स ऑफ सन और सूर्य. इट इज माइथोलॉजिकली ओरिजिनेटेड एज पर टू रेफरेंसेस अवेलेबल. As per Rasaratna Samuchaya, it is mythologically originated from the swamps of the Kartikeya, god Kartikeya. And according to Rasa Kamadhenu, it is originated from the sun god. Hence, almost all the synonyms of suns are applied for tamra synonyms. Regarding its occurrence and variety, according to Rasa Tarangani and Rasa Ratna Samuchaya, it is also of two types. Regarding the types and occurrence, Nepalam Mlechchakam Chayati Tamram Dvividham Uchyate Nepalam जात्यम आख्यातम लक्षकम त्व अवरम स्मृतम. सो नेपालको ताम्र इज कंसीडर्ड द बेटर वन एंड लक्ष इज कंसीडर्ड द इंफीरियर वन. रिगार्डिंग कलर, इट इज ऑल्सो टू टाइप्स अकॉर्डिंग टू रसार नब. द रक्त रेड वैरायटी इज कंसीडर्ड द श्रेष्ठ वैरायटी एंड द कृष्ण और ब्लैक वैरायटी इज कंसीडर्ड द inferior variety or a hair variety. Regarding its mineralogical descriptions, almost copper is pure, called native copper, rarely occurs in nature. Most copper comes from about various types of ores, combined with lead, zinc, gold, cobalt, platinum and nickel. Copper ores usually contain less than 4% coppers. Some ores may yield as little as 0.2% of copper. The copper ores are oxides, that is cuprite, for example tenorite, sulfides, that is chalcopyrite, copper pyrite, calcite, etc. Grey copper is tetrahedrite, sulfate, copper sulfate, that is jalsanite, carbonate, that is malachite, and silicates, that is chrysocolia, and fluoride, that is atacamine. Most of the world's copper comes from the mountains range extending from Alaska, USA, to the tip of South America. About 1/7 of the world's copper is mined by United States of America. Canada mines about 1/10 of world's copper. Other sources include Chile, Russia, Zaire, Zambia, Australia, Peru, China, Mexico. In India, copper mines are at Sikkim, Bhutan, Singhum, Nellore, and also in Rajasthan, Khetri. Regarding the acceptable variety, Grahya or Grahya, according to Rasaratna Samuchaya, Sita, Krishna, Varuna Chaya, Pati, Vami, Katarakam, Khyalitam Cha, Kuna, Krishnam, Metata, Nechatamrakam, Susnigdha, Mudulam, Swanam, Ghanaghataksyama, Guru, Nirvikaram, Guna Sresta, Tamram, Nepala, Muchyate. So, having white, black, reddish, if the food is changed, color is changed, it causes vomit effect, hard, and after washing it remains black. Is the characteristics of mature variety of copper, which is inferior in quality and should not be used. And characteristics of Nepal Tamra is smooth, soft, red in color, resists to heavy stroke, that is Ghanabhyata Shama, heavy and not losing its properties. Almost same characteristics are described in Asatarangani. According to Asatarangani, it is a good variety of Tamra, is having following characteristics like resist to heavy stroke, smooth, clean color like hibiscus flower, Japa Kusuma Prabham, clean color like smooth, soft, and hard, clear color like a hibiscus flower, and without the adulteration of Loha or Naga. This is a acceptable variety. Regarding it, its physical properties of copper makes it valuable to industry. They include, it is best known for its ability to conduct electricity. Silver is the only better conductor, but silver is too expensive for general use. Copper is an excellent conductor of heat, which makes it useful in cooking utensils, radiators and refrigerators, etc. Pure copper is highly malleable and can be rolled into sheets less than 0.05 millimeter thick. Copper possesses great ductility, ability to be drawn into thin wires without breaking. For example, a copper bar 4 inches square can be heated, rolled and drawn into a round wire that is thinner than a human hair. Such a wire would be more than 20 million times longer than the bar that was used to make it. Copper is quite resistant to corrosion. It will not rust in damp air. It turns from reddish orange to reddish brown. After a long exposure, copper becomes coated with a green film called patina, which protects it against further corrosion. It melts at 1083 degree centigrade and boils at 2567 degree centigrade. Copper has a density of 8.96 and various alloys of copper are prepared. They are brass, bronze, German silver, bell metal, gold metal, etc. Pure copper is unaffected by water or dilute hydrofluoric acid, but dissolves in nitric acids. Here you can see the photographs of copper. It is already known to everyone. Regarding its purifications, it is purified in two ways, that is Samanya Shodhana and Vishesha Shodhana. Regarding the Samanya Shodhana, it is common for all the metals. Thin sheets of Ashuddha Tamra is prepared, and after heating, it is quenching in the liquid media of Tila Taila, Takra, Gomutra, Aranala, that is Kanji, and Kulathakwata for 7 consecutive times. Regarding its Vishesha Shodhana, though various references are available, here we are discussing the Rasaratna Samuchaya reference. Gomutrena Pachadhyama Tamrapatram Rudagnina Suddhayate Tamram Sandeha Maranam Cha Apachyate. That is, Samanya Shodhita Tamra is subjected to Swedana Saskara with Gomutra for 1 Yama for 3 hours. Thus, Vishesha Shodhita Tamra could be occur. With some other references, it is also Tamra Nirmala Patrani Lipva Nimbambu Sindhuna Dhatva Sobiroka Shepa Dishuddha Ashtabhata. The copper sheets are coated with the paste of lemon juice and rock salt and heated on fire and dipped into the salt wells. This procedure repeated for 8 times and it is Shodhana process is completed. Moreover, it can be purified by dipping it in the juice of nirgundi, that is Vitex nirgunda or cow urine. In some procedures, the copper is melted in the crucible, and the use of yavakshyara, sajikshyara and kankada is recommended in that procedure for cutting their paste. Regarding its marana also, with various available references, Jambira rasa sampista rasa gandhaka lepita sulba patram saravasta tripateri yati panchata. Kanji is prepared by rubbing pure mercury and pure sulfur, and the fruit juice of Jambira is added to it. It is prepared in a form of paste and is the quotation on the thin sheets of copper. The sheets are then properly sealed in sarava and subjected to 3 gajaputra. By thus the copper gets converted to bhasma form. During heating process, at the time of first putra, the proportion of mercury, sulfur and copper should be equal, and at the end of this first putra, copper gets transformed into a fine powder. At the second putra, this copper powder is mixed with 1/4 quantity of each mercury and sulfur. Regarding its bhasma quality, all the bhasmas should be tested before clinical administrations. Vairkantha prabham tamram nutam bhavati kevalam pistam chunnatvam mayati sarasam yas chandrikam. Tamravasma is a bright color of peacock's neck and converts into powder form on rubbing. If tamra is to be incinerated with mercury, it would be shiny. When the incineration of copper is not properly formed, it causes 8 types of untoward effects, and one among is vamanam, virechanam. It produces bhrama also, klama also, vidaha, sweda, utklesa, etc. To counter all these bad effects, tamra is subjected to amrutikarana. To achieve the best quality of tamra, sometimes even though it fulfills the above criteria of all the doctor predictions, it manifests the symptoms like nausea, vomiting, etc. And the additional process of amrutikarana follows is your concept B. Tamra bhasma and half quantity of sulfur are processed with panchamrita. Then the card circular discs are prepared and sealed properly. It is then subjected to heat by giving 3 gajaputras. The flawless quality of tamra bhasma thus could be achieved. Regarding the properties, tamra is used for jathara and uru roga, kustha roga, and also urdhva and adhoga swadhana. And it is used for obesity, stholyapaham, durnama for pile fissure, kshaya, tuberculosis, panduroga, anemia and eye disorders. Also, it is paramalekhana, scrapping effect. It is commonly used in liver disorders like hepatitis, gallstone, cirrhosis and hepatomegaly. It stimulates the appetite and helps digestion. It works well in anemia, anasarca, abdominal pain, ascites, hyperacidity, colitis, etc. Ayurved Prakash have described 8 types of visadosa, tuasta visadosa, brahma, murcha, vidaha, sveda, kleda, vanta, aruchi, santapa, iti, etc. To counter all these bad effects, Muni Prihi is advised to take, along with Sita, sugar and dhanyaka, dhanya, thus for 3 days to counter the adverse effects. Dose and important formulations, it is advised in Rasa Tarangini for 15 milligrams to 60 milligrams, like 1/8 jati to half jati, with following important formulations of Hrudayanava rasa, Ravitandava rasa, Trimbakeshwara rasa and Suryavata rasa, etc. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0 with Vidyapeeth Annamalai University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, then mention in comment box. I will resolve it. थैंक यू।